Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Hey, man, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and drop a comment as you go through the video. And if you see something you like, see something you don't like, let me know. If you saw my short that I had posted earlier, you know what the shoe is already. I mean, really, by the thumbnail. I'm gonna put it in the thumbnail so I can get people to, to come watch the video. But we do have the strawberry cuffs. Now, everybody knows that this shoe was supposed to come out on 4/20/2020, but with everything that happened in the world, they went ahead and scratched it due to the little symbol or emoji or however you want to character on the back.
Needless to say,
so they went ahead and scratched it. Right, 3 weeks ago, Nike confirmed that the shoe was going to be re-released, or was actually going to be releasing. So everybody started scrambling, prices started dropping. I went ahead and threw a bid that I would really not mind paying. Right, nothing. It was literally half of what they were going for at the time. Somebody bid it. Cool, whatever. And then the shoe got here hella fast. I got these off of StockX. Like I said, if you didn't see my short, we'll go through that here in a bit. Got these off of StockX. They are a quick strike box. Price tag is 110. It reads Nike SB Dunk High Pro Quick Strike University Red Spinach Green. All right, I already took the shoe out because like I said, I did make a short and my son did the little unboxing, the first unboxing when I got them in the room. I took out an insole for you. So here we go. This insole is super crazy. The details on it are nice. Both shoes have the same exact insole, just one's facing the other. You got your strawberry cuff. Man, these things are fire. Now I know that the UA market had them. I know that there was a lot of early, stolen pairs out there on the market. And people are paying like $1,500 to $1,800 for these things. Now, I don't think the shoe is worth that, but that's just me. The price point I got it at was a hell of a deal, in my opinion, for a piece of history, because this shoe really is a piece of history. And when we talk about paying high resale, typically as a collector, I want a shoe that is either gonna take part and be a piece of history or already has some type of history when you do a reach back, right? This shoe is both, right? It was supposed to release, got scratched, for a major reason, this guy, and then the whole CB19 thing that was going on, and now it's releasing, and this is a marker in time, man. This really is. So I highly recommend going after a pair if you can get, if you get one for a decent price, jump on it. You can hear my stomach, man. I haven't eaten all day. I think I ate like a little Lunchable or something like that earlier, but yeah, man, this definitely is a little piece of history, so I wouldn't sleep on it. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. This suede on it is freaking crazy. Obviously, you know it's a 420 shoe made by a strand of marijuana. You got your back here, you got like a nubuck, or not nubuck, what the hell did I say nubuck? Velvet, this is like velvet, man. It's super, super soft. Your sock liner as well, which is gonna be a pain in the butt to keep clean because it's white, but this shoe is fire. Stupid fire. I love it. I'm about to throw it on foot just for the on foot, so make sure you stay tuned all the way through. Let me know what your favorite part of the shoe is, man. Mine is the little dude. Now I know he caught some flack. I know, brother. I know you caught some little flack, but yeah, man, definitely a beautiful shoe. Lucky to have it in hand. Glad I went ahead and picked it up at a decent price point. The guy bid on the bid, and man, I've been grabbing a lot of shoes that way. Really have. I've placed bids on where my price is, and it is what it is, and I just wait, and when I see the charge, I'm like, eh, cool, it's a win in my book. It does come with, like I said, if you didn't see my short, my son went ahead and ripped this damn bag off as soon as he unboxed it. That was the one thing he tried pulling on. He popped them both off. It comes with like a little pink lace right here in this bag, and then it comes with the green lace in the Nike bag. You can see where he tore that thing. My son's funny, man, but it is what it is. He actually took out the papers and put them both on foot. It does have a traditional stash pocket in the tongue. And yeah, same thing on both shoes. I like them both, comes with both laces. I don't know if I would swap out any of the laces because it has this gradient look right here where that pink from the other set of laces. I don't know if I'd swap it out. I think it looks good that way, unless you put the green. The green might look dope. The green might set it off because it's a different green than this little mid part right here. But yeah, man, Hope you guys enjoyed the content, man. And yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and throw these on foot. Thanks for hanging out.
Peace.